Hey everyone, it's Simon here from Higher Plane Games. I hope you're well and having a great day. Welcome to the latest episode of Firewatch. We completed day one last time round, and we're now on to day two of the game, and we're off to go and see what's happened with a broken wire that's off overhead. I can remember where it's supposed to be. In this rather gorgeous game, we got our compass, but we've also got our map. So we are looking to go up to possibly Beartooth Point, I think. I think. We shall double check. So, it's looking nice and gorgeous out here today. Jonesy Lake. Now, I'm kind of sure that we're going off in the same direction. Let me just triple. No, we want to go off this way. We've already gone that way. There we go. Note to everyone, don't go orienteering with me. You'll all be doomed. Because it's going back to where we were. So we've got the slightly evil outhouse, of course. Which looks slightly less scary in the day, it must be said. Although I don't think I'd want to have a big ginormous poo in it. Bar. Stinky. Even the yeah, now we can. Now we're off in the right direction. Plop. Probably break a leg doing that with my ginormous man boobs. Oh, it's the base. It's an old base. Such a litter bug. I just want to like go on a mass cleaning. I like that it's still there. That's good.
Oh, it's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
I don't know. Used to just spend a lot of time with our dog, Bucket.
Aw, that's a good name.
He was a good dog.
What type?
A beagle. We got him from the pound.
That's great. Hey, can you hold on a sec?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you? Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea. I'm absolutely sure. Would you? All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard. Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, Bucket's a cute name. You owned him with someone?
That would be my wife, Julia.
Oh, like your wife, or like she's taken half my stuff, wife?
My wife.
But you're here.
She's sick, and I shouldn't be here, but I am.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, you are are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Yeah, sure.
Like, I gotta go do a thing, but I'll have a radio. Okay, call me if you need to.
Suspicious. Sausage. Suspicious sausage. I've got some... I have some Polish friends. I used to take the mick out the way how they would... Neither of them could say sausage. They'd call it sausage. So I just go, ah. Oh. When I'd go out and do our run for lunch, I'd be like, would you like some sausages? So yes. What was that? I chose not to go with it because I think I'm going to play this as a as an open book, Henry. For my liking. It's still locked. 452. That sound. And this looks much more gorgeous now that it's in daytime as well, as opposed to the big sunset. I love the way how the weather changes as you go through the part of the journey that you're supposed to. We got everything out of here, didn't we? Yeah, we did. So we have now reached... Oh, wrong button. L Point. So we're looking at going up the thoroughfare trail, aren't we? I think. Because as you can see with the dotted line, we've got the telephone cable that's going on there. So it's cutting across where we are and where we need to go. And so you can see like the dotted line cutting across the red line as we go up. So we'll kind of follow those points through. And we'll intersect it at some point. It's me sounding like I'm vaguely... So we can juggle. But I'm going to stay nice and relax. Oh, butterfly. The most pointless hop over ever. Let's do it. What was that? Gap in bush. Let's clear the gap. Gap in brush, not gap in bush. Interesting. Is that a typo? I think so. So yes, what is Delilah up to on the other call, I wonder? As we make our way through the morning mist. Sound. It's probably me. Firewatchers must get paid not a lot for the vast expanse of land that they have to cover and the responsibility that they've got. Here's telephone cable, can you see? Yeah. Okay.
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
We'll follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it.
Thanks, Delilah, for ever sending me on an errand, girl. Bushy.
So we really can't reach anyone any other way than these wires?
What else do you suggest? Smoke signals?
Just seems dangerous.
Well, if they don't hear from me for a few days, they'll send someone out, but I'd rather it not come to that.
You were just talking to someone else, though, Delilah, you dirtbag. Okay, a thoroughfare fire lookout. Aloha! Blah, 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 blah. All of the Fs. Or Fs, rather. Right, so that then continues to go that way, so that's okay. We'll kind of circumnavigate it back round. I can see, I want to see what's in here. Hello?
Hey, I found a structure that might have been an outhouse once, I think.
Whoa, you don't need my permission to go to the bathroom, but, you know, use abandoned shitters at your own peril.
I mean, I'm in the right area?
I do believe. The comms wire runs for quite a ways. Follow it all the way to the top of Beartooth Point, and if it's not damaged, you can loop around back home.
This outhouse is in the middle of nowhere.
Well, I hate to tell you, but everything out here is in the middle of nowhere.
You know what I mean. Am I on the right track?
Just keep following the wire to the top of the ridge, and then you can head back.
Oh, hello.
Anything I should know about the cabin at the top of this hill? Hello? Okay, then.
Hello? Ooh, hello. So many goods to have. Such little time.
Huh. Found an old hat from a Korean War vet.
You'd be surprised how many former service members take this gig.
Well, makes sense.
I imagine if you've been through war, you probably can't get enough silence.
Cool, got a cap. Less sunburn. Let's go play with the cabin in the woods. Literally the cabin in the woods. Ooh. Wow. Hello? Wow. Health and safety would have a field day here. Love it. It still looks maybe minorly used, unless stuff like that doesn't decay very quickly. You can't go down though. Let's see. Oh, maybe you can. Oh. Burned bed. Someone's been busy. I like how dramatic that opening was. I've not act- So I have played through this game before, but I didn't actually know you could get down here, so this is new for me. As a music man, that makes me very sad. The doing. Interesting. Okay. All right, well, let's go up then. I don't see anything else down there. Is that on the wall? I can't see what that's on the wall. Cool. I like rummaging out of the way of things. Right, so we've got that. Right, let's continue on the way since it's now. Looks like the morning fog is clearing slightly, if not cleared completely. Down on the farm. Down on the farm. Hawk's Rest, we've called that. Okay. Fair enough, D. So we could have gone left or right through that bit. We went right off on a little mini tangent. But all roads seem to lead back to this place anyway, so that's okay. So this all looks good. Down in the valley. Ah, oh, okay. Hear something else.
Hey, I can see your tower. Suppose that means you can see me.
Yeah, well enough.
You wake up pretty early then, huh?
Soon as the sun comes up. Forest Service really frowns on us putting up curtains for some reason.
I just covered my head with my pillow. Seems to do the trick.
Wow. The forest could never burn down on your watch.
Can you see the communication wires from where you are?
I can see the poles, but I have no idea if the wire's in good shape or not. They run a good distance up to a spot called Beartooth Point. You just need to walk along them all the way up there and make sure everything's in ship shape.
Which is what we're doing, Delilah. And that does not look ship shape to me. But I also see. Oh, hello. Let's do a usual smithy and take the rear entrance. Right, I'm gonna. Before we do anything, I love me a supply cache. Update the map. What's that given us? Oh, it's given us lots of other different little bits and bobs there, and a supply drop up on the top. So that's good. Let's bring that down. What else have we got? Some more flora and fauna.
who are these guys Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance one of them was that guy I saw in the canyon? You know, the guy with the flashlight?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
That is gorge. Right. So we've read that. Let's hold that. Let's keep all the notes. The love boat. What's the board? Ooh. It's just a board. Oh, that's helpful. 6 feet down under. Haven't we already got that book? Oh. Simon. Put it back. Oh, fine. I feel permanently like I need to try and get everything back in the fucking box. Come on! Oh, fine. Please put the book back in. Thank you. There we go. That's as good as it will get, I'm afraid. Okay. What are we up to? We have got...
Okay, the wire's down here.
Really? Awesome. Good find.
It's like, I don't know, a mile and a half east of me. You just follow the trail up the hill, you can't miss it. I'll go see what the damage is.
Yes, let's. Oh, is that more that I can do with a tower? No, I've already done it all. Right. So we've got this. We'll have to go up that way. Okay. Oh no, we'll have to go down and round. Or can we drop off? There you go. Expertly dismounted, sir. Still hear like rustlings. Oh, hello.
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before.
Yep.
These fucking kids.
Why do you think they'd be up here?
Hell if I know, but they better have stayed away from our communication stuff.
Skanky children. We need to get back down. You skanky children. I like the way how the trees have all bent, like the wind has gnarled them up. Gnarly dude! Interesting.
Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it. The moment you said you found their trash, these idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
Nice panties. Clear up that environment, Smithy. Okay, so teenage bitches have cut our wires. Grr! Makes my angries. So we. Sorry. I'm going to follow this round and we're going to go down towards cache 241, I believe. It's all wank buckets. Dead end. Just a little quick joggeroo. So it looks like we are a bit. No, we can get through here. Or can we? No, we can't. We don't got the goods. So we gotta get back on that road. Assuming we can't go through there. No, we can't. On the road again. Oh, hello.
Well, I hopped down a drop and now I can't climb back up.
That is a pickle.
I can just keep hiking, but I figured I should let you know in case I get myself trapped out here.
Well, hopefully that doesn't happen before you find these assholes. I was thinking you should probably head back to where you saw him last.
Okay. Ah, there we go. Sorry. Mild confusion. Essentially, just follow the beer can trail. How much beer do they want to do? Okay, that can get us back up. That's good. As someone who has, as a child, gone out camping and got rather drunk in the woods sometimes. Ah, hello. How did we miss all of these various different ways of getting across here? Right, so where are we wanting to go? So that was the way down that was blocked with the brambles, wasn't it? So we're okay for now. Do a little mini run to kind of catch up with where we really should be, if I wasn't getting confused and lost there for a minute or two. Apologies for that. Aha! And here we have it. Okay. So I believe we do look at the supply drop later on in the game. And she's pointing us that way anyway, isn't she? So we're going to continue this way for now. Gorgy views as we go. Gorgy views. You know what I mean. Oh. Luggage. I'm a lumberjack. La 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 la. Oh, hello.
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Don't mind if I do. Ooh, hello. Rope!
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
What, was he a fella you had a thing with?
Yeah, it was so hot and heavy. Of course, Brian Goodwin was 12 years old, so, you know, our love could never really be understood. I'm kidding. Not about him being an actual 12-year-old. part's true. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Why? Where did they go?
I don't know. I never really hit it off with old Ned, and one day they were just gone. Sucks. Anyway, so it goes. Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photodome employee.
I don't know. I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Oh, my inner perv is already ready at work. Okay. Let's rappel our way down. And that's cool because that will now be available to climb in L Futures. Ooh, how do I get down? Ooh, another one. Okay. Such a good man at chucking rope. Got skills, bro. Remember in my only ever like daredevil sports thing that I've ever done in real life, I'd done some abseiling off like a, I think it was about a three story building thing. And my rappelling down that was a slow and painful, to say the least. I'm not great with heights. And that proved it for me. As I gently shat myself dribbling down the cliff. Oh dear. So we've got some more map information. Here we go. What we got? Oh, these map informations are so handy. So that's given us more up to the supply drop, which is quite interesting. We've got some more different ways to go for a cash point and a little okay, so you've got the little rope stuff there as well. That makes more sense. And that can get us back to Jonesy Lake one of two ways by the looks of it, which is quite cool. We need that's 5 Mile Creek. Wow, we're all the way down there. Okay. Right. Is there anything else juicing it? Oh, hello.
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Could be the same person who left that antler.
Maybe they're leaving me an entire creature, piece by piece.
Oh, Ron. Vandal? Okay. Oh, hello.
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards Five Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood. Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
Oh, Henry will do too. This game always just makes me like want to talk and to my girl. Right, so we're gonna go all the way down that way, and we'll come out of Five Mile Creek, so that's all good. Fab. Right, well, let's get a hike in.
What does she have?
She's got Alzheimer's, like dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
We were scared shitless. We went straight to the doctor after her first spell or whatever. They diagnosed her and we were both just very scared. Can't really tell when Julia is scared. She just gets quiet. She was very quiet.
Love that. Let's get a butterfly. Is it me, or does it feel like it's already starting to get a little bit darker?
I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Oh, man.
What? Do you like that? This guy is the freaking king of the flapjacks.
Yeah, that's solid. I'll have to keep that one in my pocket.
It's all yours.
Just make sure we are actually going the right way. Yes, we are. Okay, so we've got two little things that we can try here. Ooh, I like that tree. So we've got just quickly dive over. Is it over here that we're going? Yeah, we are vaguely in the right direction. Now, is this an up or uppy or a downy? If that makes sense to people. Because it's a rope tie off. So then at least that like shortcut is covered. I'm not necessarily, are we going down that one though? Let's dive up. So no, that's handy, but actually I think we'll dive off the other one, but it's more shortcuts that we can play with, so that's all cool. Let's do a quick runaroo. Ah, there stairs. I was like, how do we get down? That's how. Climb down, Henry. Your knees. So my main.
So, how'd you meet?
Met in a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I walked over and asked her what her major was because I thought she was a student, not a prof.
Smooth.
That's me. I did make the first move, though.
Aw, you were brave.
I was drunk.
Oh, wow. Get obsessed with the camera, right. Let's rappel down, and then I think that will be the end of this episode of Firewatch this week. Unless there's some discussion down at the bottom here.
Wow, I'm on top of a natural bridge out here.
Really? Is it a complete arch?
No, I guess the bridge is out here. Still, I think I could jump this gap to get across the canyon.
Wow, you're a regular Evel Knievel.
Oh yeah, you should see the jumpsuit I'm wearing.
Good jump, Henry. Good jump. Of the rocks. I'm really at cache 306 again before we get down to 5 Mile Creek. So, thank you very much for watching this episode of Firewatch. As always, please do subscribe and say hello if you enjoyed what I do here. There's a video every single day on Higher Plane Games. And if you feel it that you'd like to support myself as an independent creator across all of the different projects that I run here on YouTube, higherplanegames.com, higherplanemusic.com too. Then there is a Patreon, and the link to that is in the description of the video. Take care all. Bye for now.